In this video, we're going to answer the question, for a ring final circuit, when would I use a 20 amp double pole switch and when would I use a switched fuse spur? Now this question relates to the video we made recently on the quite excellent Verso modular switching system. So if you haven't seen that already, then please do go and check it out. But to return to this question, sometimes in a kitchen, we'll install a switch to disconnect an appliance where the socket isn't readily accessible, like say, an appliance with a socket behind it or at the back of a cupboard. If we're connecting off a ring final circuit, then the 2.5mm squared cable from switch to socket is effectively protected with a 32 amp protective device. This cable can't handle that amount of current. However, in Appendix 15 of BS7671, we find that to feed one socket, this is an acceptable arrangement. The reasoning being that one double socket is never really likely to draw a full 26 amps for extended periods of time. So in this situation, using a 20 amp double pole switch to disconnect the socket is perfectly acceptable. But where does this value of 20 amps come from? Well, if we turn to Regulation 433.1.204, we read, accessories to BS1363 may be supplied through a ring final circuit with or without unfused spurs protected by a 30 or 32 amp protective device. The circuit shall be wired with copper conductors having lined and neutral conductors with a minimum cross-sectional area of 2.5 mm. Such circuits are deemed to meet the requirements of Regulation 433.1.1 if the current carrying capacity of the cable is not less than 20 amps and if, under the intended conditions of use, the load current in any part of the circuit is unlikely to exceed for long periods the current carrying capacity of the cable. So this regulation is implying that in a properly installed ring final circuit, the most current likely to flow through either leg of the ring is 20 amps. Hence, we can use a 20 amp double pole switch for the purpose we described earlier. So when would we use a switched fused spur instead? Well, there's a few scenarios, a couple of which are outlined in Appendix 15 of the regs, where we see that if you feed more than one socket outlet off a spur, then you'll need to use a fused connection unit, or spur as it's commonly known, to protect the outgoing cable as it could become overloaded. It's interesting, this appendix also gives us the option to reduce the cable CSA to 1.5 mm after the fused connection unit. But in reality, this isn't common practice. So there we go. That's why we can use a 20 amp double pole switch, or why we may have to use a fused connection unit. But as always, we want to hear from you. Which switching device do you prefer if given the option? Do you have any other questions on ring final circuits? As always, please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments section below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.